Hi, my name is Bob Greenyer, and I'm a volunteer with the Martin Fleischmann Memorial Project. So, in this cracked ball, there appears to be some sort of structure inside which has a lot of lighter elements apparently synthesized in there. And what I want to do is I want to look in the center of these because there appears to be potentially some material that is heavier than the stuff on the outside. So if I zoom in here, you can see that this has almost got rings, ring, 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 ring. Is this formed from fractal toroidal structures? I don't know, but potentially we are seeing something in the center of that there, in the center of this, in the center of this. So I want to see if these have got higher concentrations of iron in these central pieces. Okay. And the backscatter electron here should give us a better idea. So what I'm referring to really is, if you look here, there seems to be a ball here in the center of this. There seems to be a circular bit here, maybe a circular bit here, and this chunk here, which could be detritus coming from somewhere else, but there's also a bit here, but it's very close to the wall. There's another bit here. So I want to see if those central parts are higher in concentration of iron. Maybe I'll even do a line scan across here. So I think we'll take the overall establishing shot of our little collection here. As we have done previously. And okay, we'll zoom into that. We'll do one shot with the whole ball in, as best as we can get it, which is, I guess, at 2000. And then I think what I'll do is I'll take a four quadrant shot of this. I'm going to actually try and get all of these structures in view so we get a full map of that. Okay, so we're going to go in for the shot, which we're going to use as the basis of our SEM study EDX data. And it is this kind of feature here, this ball here, this one here, this one here, this one here, that I want to see if they have heavier elements in them, in the center of these circles. You can see it's quite clear there, quite clear. There's another one there, another one in the center of this, another one in the center of that, another one in the center of that. Center there, center there, center there. So this is what we're going to be looking for. Be interesting to see what it reveals. So we're transferring now over to the EDX detector. So our points of interest are these balls here and here and here and here and here, particularly, that are in the center of these toroidal structures. So we're going to do this one, possibly this one, and this one, and this one maybe. This is a bit close to the collapse stage, so we might need to avoid that. So first up, this one. So interestingly, it has some copper in there, and iron, and 25% by mass of calcium. So let's have a look at what this is by atomic concentration normalized. 2.2% of the atoms, 2.3% of the atoms are copper, 4.7% are iron, 14.7% are calcium, silicon 6.16%, aluminium 2.65%. Still, the majority is carbon and oxygen, but a lot of other elements here in this central spot. Now, there clearly are some other peaks here, and I think we can safely say this is probably magnesium here, this one here, and this one might be phosphorus here, and this one might be sulfur. What is that one? Is that potassium there? Yes. So we'll add that to our report. This is our report, and what we can do is we add things to it. So I'll go here, and it's still determining there, so we'll leave that for the minute. Chlorine line here is just a little bit underwhelming. sorry, it's finished doing its sampling there. You see the calcium peak is very, very certain, and that is 27% by mass, 27.26. That is the highest concentration of any element there. So if you take calcium and oxygen together, that constitutes nearly, in fact, over 50% of the mass of this material in here. Okay, so we're going to add this to the report as well. And so what we see is our sample point here and our spectrum here. And if we add this to the report, we'll see that it puts our lovely table here with our mass normalization and our atom percent there. Okay, so I think what we're going to do next is some of the area around the ball we've just looked at, to see how that compares with it. So I think we'll take this bit here, just a little bit under there. See how that turns out. Wow. Very different ratios there, right? Much, much more silicon. Much, much more aluminium. Much less calcium. I would suggest there might even be, no, not sodium, rather. So essentially, it's lowered the amount of calcium there, and the other elements have increased. Seems to have finished determining that. So well, let's have a look at another one of these central spots. There's one down here. Let's see if we can actually grab that. In the center of there. So it is interesting to see that many of these spots do contain some copper. This has less copper in it, and much less iron, much less calcium, It is much more skewed to carbon and oxygen here. But again, we'll have a look on the periphery. Seems to have acquired that now, so we'll go here. And that is a lot of silicon. So when I said that some of the charging area in here to me would imply some silicon dioxide, suddenly we are getting some silicon in there. But most of it here, my mass, is carbon and oxygen. In fact, if you go and look at actually the atoms there, you can see that 93% of the atoms in this area here are carbon or oxygen. The vast majority of the atom mass. So I think the next one we want to look at the image here, is probably this one here. So we'll look at that. It's big enough to be reasonably certain we're going to hit it this time. What do we see? So, a lot of calcium. Again, same sort of constituent amount of calcium in there as the first center spot we looked at. Bearing in mind the outside crust here, and we'll do a spot on it for argument's sake, is almost entirely iron, oxygen, and carbon. None of these elements are present. Maybe we'll take this edge here. In this particular point, we've got reasonably detectable amount of phosphorus this time. Magnesium is up at 1%. So I'm going to take one on this edge here. So we will acquire that spot, which is this one here. Yeah, so that is basically iron, oxygen, and calcium. As you can see, by mass, 40% iron, 42%, let's say, of oxygen, the balance is carbon. I'll do one more up here, just so that it's in the same data set. Here in this instance up here, It's 49% iron, 39% oxygen, and the balance is carbon. So we're going to have a look at a couple of other sample points. I'd like to look at this one, but unfortunately it's kind of buried under that five there. I'm going to see if I can get it anyway. Let's see if I can. And there's this one here. We could do that one first, but I'm going to go for that one under there. And I think we can do this one. Where is it? It is there. Right, we'll get it sampling both of those. Wow, look at the silicon on that. It's quite a high signal of silicon in this particular one. Wow, almost exclusively silicon, oxygen and carbon, so basically silicon dioxide. So in conclusion, the shell here and here are essentially iron and oxygen. The cores of these structures, these kind of structures, have a whole selection of elements in them, it would appear. A range of the typically synthesized elements you get. Okay. And in the surrounding areas, it's a bigger spread of the elements, but it's heavier typically in the central parts of these structures. It would be nice if we had the luck to find another split iron-rich crenellated sphere with its guts revealed, as we see here. But for now, that is all I want to do with this one. So thank you very much for your time, and I will see you in the next video.